विराट सर्टनली स्ट्रगल्ड विद आई कॉन्टैक्ट. सो इफ आई सी द ओल्ड फोटोज नाउ आई कैन ट्रूली रिलेट दैट येस देर वर सिम्टम्स शोइंग अप, देर वर रेड फ्लैग्स, आई कॉन्टैक्ट वॉज पुअर बिकॉज आई डिड नॉट नो दैट आई कॉन्टैक्ट हैज़ सच अ बिग इम्पॉर्टेंस इन किड्स. यू नो किड इट इज़ अ माइल्ड स्टोन दैट योर किड शुड एक्चुअली हैव अ गुड आई कॉन्टैक्ट. बट विराज वॉज नॉट हैविंग इट. वी हैड वेरी फ्यू मोमेंट्स वेयर वी कुड गेट अ आई कॉन्टैक्ट और ही वॉज लुकिंग एट द सेल्फी वेन वी वर क्लिकिंग अ सेल्फी फ्रॉम अ कैमरा. येस ही लाइक टू बी कडल. सो इफ समबडी हैज़ पुट इन अ नोशन इन यू दैट दीज किड्स डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू बी लव्ड, इट्स एब्सोल्यूटली रॉन्ग. दे वॉन्ट टू बी लव्ड एंड दे विल कडल यू वेन दे वॉन्ट एंड यू कैन गो एंड कडल यू एंड किस एंड शावर देम विद लव बिकॉज दैट्स वॉट यू डू एंड दैट्स वॉट दे एक्सपेक्ट यू टू डू. सो विराज वॉन्टेड टू बी लव्ड एंड वी जस्ट हग्ड हिम, प्लेड विद हिम, कडल्ड हिम एंड वेन एवर वी यूज टू डू दैट ही वॉज हैप्पी. ही यूज टू स्माइल एट अस, ही वॉज हैप्पी, ही वॉज चेयरफुल, ही वॉज प्लेफुल. बट आई कॉन्टैक्ट वॉज वन थिंग दैट नाउ आई नो दैट इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड यू हैव टू वर्क हार्ड ऑन गेटिंग एन आई कॉन्टैक्ट. सेकेंड वॉज फॉलोइंग द कमांड्स. कमांड फॉलोइंग वॉज आई वुड नॉट से इट वॉज वेरी पुअर और एबसेंट बट येस कमांड फॉलोइंग वॉज वेरी रिस्ट्रिक्टेड. फॉर लॉट ऑफ कमांड्स वर द ओनली कमांड्स द विराज कुड फॉलो वर विच वर रिपीटेड ऑन द डेली बेसिस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल गो टू वॉशरूम एंड यू नो डोंट टच इट, नो विराज. इट वॉज प्रोमिनेंट इनफ दैट ही कुड अंडरस्टैंड दोज पर्टिकुलर कमांड्स बिकॉज दे वर रिपीटेड. We also bought him some books because he was always engaged in ABCD and you know numbers and I believe that in autism there is one thing that is called hyperlexic when you are very much inclined towards numbers and letters. So we saw that Viraj had a fabulous pictorial memory. Nest. He just saw once or he just listened to something once and he used to memorize it and repeat it very very quickly. So that his visual stimulation was activated very much. His pictorial memory was amazing. The most important thing that I later got to know is engagement with other children. His engagement with other children was pretty low. He was very easily annoyed with other children because either he did not want to wanted to play with them or either he did not know how to initiate a play with them. So he was quite annoyed when some child used to, you know, come by and play near him. So these were few signs that were alarming, but since we do not know how autism looks like or what it is and we take it as a nature of the child or personality traits of a child, that's why we ignore these things. So I just wanted to introduce you by these clips and these images. I just wanted to show you that, you know, autism does not comes on your face. It is not something that you can look a child and you can just immediately tell that it's autism. You see a child and if a child is shy, he or she would not look at you or they would not talk to you for about 10-20 minutes and they would just sit at one place. They would act like they are not from this world. But autism is something wherein you know, I hear this a lot, he does not look autistic. Being autistic does not come on face. It is not something, you know, you do not have any kind of impairment on your face that shows up or anything. It's a completely wrong notion when people say that my child does not look autistic. So autism is not that comes in your looks, it's your behavior, it's a communication deficit. When you are unable to communicate with your environment, and when I talk about environment, it's definitely with people around, definitely with lots of things around. When you are not involved with your environment and you are in your own world doing a self-talk or you are very quiet or looking at something with very deep focus, but you are not focusing on the entire world which is around you and you are simply in your own world and you want to be in that world. If somebody is there and disturbing you from that thing, then you easily get annoyed. So I was never aware that this is autism, and when I started researching about it, then I got to know, okay, this is what autism is. So that's just a clip wherein I wanted to introduce you who Viraj is and why we are here for this whole purpose. So he is my purpose, he is the purpose of my life, he is an amazing kid. We have come a long way from the pictures and how he is now. So for the latest updates, in next video I will be showing up some clips of him, and also I will be telling you that what are different things that you can do with your child, for example different types of therapies, because trust me, going to each and every therapy is financially draining, and it takes a lot of money to be invested. So I made a decision 2 months ago that I will not be going to any therapies. I will be learning a lot from the internet. I will be learning from my resources. I will be learning from the therapist, and I will try and implement everything which I know, and I will make a plan, experiment, and then find out whether I am getting benefits out of it. And by God's grace, whatever I have learned and whatever I am implementing with Viraj is truly bringing out a change in him, and he is now more playful, more happy. And I will also tell you about dance therapy, which you might not have heard about, related to autism, but there is this dance therapy that I read somewhere and I tried it with Viraj. That's more of what you do in preschool. You play the rhymes and you dance on that, and the children come and dance with you. But there are different types of dance therapies that you can do, and there is a way that you do a dance therapy with an autistic child to involve them, and this helps you in building eye contact. So I am going to talk about these all therapies which you can do at home, but specifically I will definitely talk about dance therapy which you can do at home, and this will help your child to be involved with you. This is a way to bond you and your child, and have a good eye contact.